Good morning, guys. It is Saturday, the 29th of July, 2017, day two of Yowk at London Film and Comic Con. It is a few minutes to eight. I'm actually getting out and up a bit earlier today. I'm very tired, running on about 3-4 hours sleep. And I'm very excited for the weekend, the rest of the weekend. Can't even do words properly. Right, I'm going to go to the tube station, get a tube to Yowk, and I should vlog a bit more when I get there.
You're watching Newcomes.
Right, got the tube, managed to do some reading. Now, I've got 14 minutes until doors open, 29 minutes until my first panel that I want to see, and need to grab some books if I can, some proofs and arts and all that good stuff. But I need to get there and I'm 6 minutes away. Time to stop vlogging and start power walking. So I've made it to Yowk. I managed to get a copy of The Fandom from my friend Alexandra, but there wasn't any Zenith arcs yet. They've said to keep an eye on Twitter for that, so that's what I'm going to do. Now I'm going to go into the New Voices 1 panel.
Has been so far, or the most surprising, or both.
I think the best thing has been that sense, oh, this is so X-Factory, but that sense of having a dream come true, that actually I'm an author, and I feel like a complete imposter. I feel like this is one of those kind of dreams you have where everyone you know is there, and then you wake up and it's a bit disappointing. But yeah, so for me, it's been that this is real, and that I'm allowed to write books. It's really lovely.
A few years ago when I read The Hunger Games, actually, and I was really inspired by that series, and I loved the YA voice, and I thought, well, maybe I'll try this. So I sat down and I wrote another book and I actually finished it. And it was a terrible dystopian knockoff. It had like a love triangle, it had an evil future government, it had like every trope you could think of, and I just threw it all in there. I was like, this is great, this is gonna be huge. And 85 agents disagreed with me vehemently. Didn't go anywhere, so I wrote a second book. And by that time I, you know, met other writers, I was starting to exchange work, I realized I had a ways to go before I was actually publishable. So the second book also didn't go anywhere. But then I got the idea for One of Us is Lying, and I wrote that pretty quickly in a couple months, and I revised it in a couple months, and I too had a color-coded spreadsheet, and my agent was right at the top. And I wasn't sure if the book was ready, and I thought, you know what, she's gonna reject me, I'm just gonna send it, and I'll get it out of my system. And she requested in like an hour, and I was like, oh, no, not ready, the book's not ready. And I madly revised it for another 5 days, and then I actually sent it to her. And then things happened pretty quickly. So it took me 3 books, but once I hit on the right idea, it took off.
I literally just ran out of the panel because they're now seeing the proofs, and there is a huge, huge queue. So I missed out on the Zenith arc by about 3 people. There was such a huge crowd and I literally ran from the panel. I saw the tweet and I ran and I didn't get there in time. That is insane. I am absolutely gutted. Fingers crossed I can get one a bit later because they're going to be doing more. I've got to keep an eye on Twitter. Now I'm going to head to the signings for some authors. Right, well, I missed out on that arc. But I'm in the queue to meet Karen and McManus. I was in the queue for Alice Broadway, but it got cut off because it was a long queue, literally in front of me. Time to get One of Us is Lying signed. So I've just met Karen and McManus. Do you want to tell everyone about your book?
Sure, my book is kind of like The Breakfast Club, but with murder. It's called One of Us is Lying.
It's fantastic. You should definitely go and check it out.
I hope you do.
So, I didn't vlog with Alice Broadway because her queue is enormous and constantly growing. But I got a picture which I'll put in here. I it was really lovely to meet her. Now I'm going to head to the Galanx stall because there's some sort of giveaway or something happening in about 10 minutes.
It's a bit strong relationship themes, and it's all about power struggles, and you want to read something that ideally will make you turn the page, like, and page, and page, and page, then you might like one. I can't promise it, but I would give you, I'm 98% confident. So, especially after you've had a lovely, lovely cupcake. So please have a cupcake and enjoy the rest of the time.
I got a cupcake and a sampler. Nice. So I've sat on the floor to eat a cupcake, which was really good. And just have a rest for a few minutes. And someone just walked past, handing out samplers. And I thought, passport? E. Lockhart sampler of her next book. That's really cool. Time for some awkward left-hand vlogging, but the Penguin platform area, the little stall, have a stall sort of slash thing for lemonade, for Juniper Lemon's Happiness Index, which is a book I keep hearing about that's supposed to be pretty good. Might get it this weekend, I don't know. And I've got some free lemonade. So it's 11:45, V.E. Schwab has a signing at 1 p.m. They've just put the name up over there on the board, and there is already, within 2 minutes, a good 45 people. It's in an hour and a quarter. That's insane. I'd like to meet her again and get it signed. I don't know if it's going to happen. I'm going to see how things go. Now, I'm just going to keep wondering. Well, V. Schwab's queue is enormous already, so I'm going to go and see her in a panel about genre bending.
Give us a little introduction, just saying your name and what book you wrote.
My name's Martin Stewart. I wrote Riverkeep, and my next book is The Sacrifice Box, which is coming out in January.
Hi, it's Michelle. I'm the author of Sorcerer to the Crown, which is a historical fantasy novel. It's about England's first African sorcerer royal, and he has so many problems.
My name is Ben Ronvich. I write the Rivers of London series, which is about policemen that do magic, basically.
Hi there, I'm V.E. Schwab. I write the Shades of Magic series and the Monsters of Verity duology. I write about strange things that don't fit into one genre.
And I'm Dan Villetta, and I'm the author of Smoke, which is about sin and dark vapors coming out of the body if you've been naughty, which is why I'm wearing a black shirt. Perry and Sally will end up together, and then, you know, and Sally ends up with Megan, you know, and it's nice, you have that, huh, didn't see that coming, it's surprising. But also try to remind myself when I watch a movie, and you know, part of me might be going, this is cheesy, I'm not involved. But the rest of me is kind of, you know, looking for the handkerchief. And I'd be really bummed if they don't kiss at the end, right? Like, that would be a slow. So I think, I mean, as you say, it's a kind of push and pull. But I think it's less, I mean, there's certainly a moment where you think, huh, I thought this plot is going here, but what if I do this? And that violation can be very exciting. Also for yourself, I think.
I'm definitely, while I'm a genre blender, I am a very purposeful trope subverter. And I think that, you know, tropes exist within that category as like kind of the sub-categories within genre. I take great pleasure in subverting expectations, but I do think that's a thing that's separate from the kind of umbrella of genre. The thing that I don't like about the umbrella of genre is it's, from a marketing perspective, it's a mode of delineation. It's a mode of narrowing to one category, to one category, to one category, and I don't like it as a reader because I don't discover things outside of my expectations if I only limit myself to one section of the bookstore, and I don't like it as a writer because I'm ornery and contrarian and I don't like boxes. But I love finding ways to violate expectations, to take, like, my favorite thing to do is with antagonists. I like a long con that takes an antagonist in book one, or in the first time you meet them, you think, I hate that person. And then by the end of book three, I want you to be completely invested in that person. So for me, it takes specific forms, but nothing makes me happier than being surprised. Better than anything else, it's just a divide. And literary comes along and makes it a hierarchy. it tips the divisions on its side, and suddenly one thing is better than another thing, one thing is below another thing. And I blame it for a lot, because then you start getting into these smaller genre divides of, is science fiction superior to fantasy? Because a lot of people who are not well versed in the two will say, oh, but science fiction has rules, and in fantasy you can do whatever you want. And so they start, and then YA gets shifted below everything, and it just goes down and down and down. So like, I blame literary for turning section dividers into a ladder. So I hate it just on premise of that. But I also read a lot of it. I think there are good examples out there, but I do think it's a problematic, like, it's the intruder. It came into the party and it was like very much holier than thou against everyone else in the party.
So the genre bending panel was really good. I left it early because they just got into audience questions, and YAHQ, who are the ones giving out copies of Zenith, keep dropping tweets saying, okay, we have a new arc or a new proof, and I need to be out and about and ready for the next Zenith drop. So I've just sat here relaxing, and this lovely Faye came over to say hi. She has a website, which you should go and check out. If I remember, I'll put it in the description. How's your Yelp going?
Amazing. I saw the authors for Grenfell Yelp tickets, so they're VIP. So I get to go in the green room and pack queues and just get amazingness. So it's indescribable, really.
Oh, well, I hope you enjoy the rest of it.
You
too. Thank you for coming up and saying hi.
That's all right.
So I was halfway through lunch and the Zenith Klaxon went off again. Got here 1 minute later. What a queue. Wow, I missed out again. I don't know if they're going to have any more today. If not, maybe tomorrow, but that's insane. I literally ran to like a minute. I got up as quick as I could. I was eating, saw the tweet, got up, ran. Got there within 1 minute, and there were about 30 people, and they've gone. I'm gonna go sit in a panel room for a bit now.
I love kind of, you know, like romantic comedies. I just do and I'm a huge Nora Ephron fan, and so, you know, You've Got Mail, Sleepless in Seattle, all of these books are really
while you were sleeping, all of that,
and then, you know, they're not being made as much anymore, and but it's just, there's a whole kind of like classic, you know, bunch of them from like the 80s, 90s, 2000s that I love those. They're the kinds you can watch 8 million times, and even though you own one DVD, you can't help watching it every time it comes on your TV. You're like, why am I watching the commercials? I have the DVD, but...
Well, I made it to that panel for about the last 2-3 questions. Now I'm going to go to the Lauren James signing queue, because she's an amazing author. If you haven't checked out her books, you should. So I was in the queue for Lauren James signing. Then a very close by stall announced an arc, and I ran, and I didn't get it. So I went back, met Lauren once again. I've met her quite a few times now. She's really lovely. And I got my book signed, and I got a picture, drop it in here. She's such a sweet, loving person. I'm going to try and vlog with her a bit later, but I didn't want to vlog at the time because she's got quite a queue. So I just sat down for a bit to have a little break and a little rest. And then I bought another book at the Hocking Books store. I actually saw them tweet out that they had 5 copies of the book that sounded awesome to give away. But I had a dead leg, so I couldn't get it. But I got another one that sounded really good. Now I'm going to get in the queue for the Schwab and hope I can meet her. She's been signing for a good 2 hours now, maybe more. 30 minutes later, and I'm very, very close to the front of the queue and to meet Via Schwab. They've said no pictures with her because there is a huge queue all the way to the other side of the hall. Which is awesome. I'm so excited to get to meet her. 35 minutes of queuing 10 seconds with Victoria Schwab, but it was wonderful. We had a little chat about the second duology that was amazing that I just recently finished. And she was lovely. Got it signed. I'm going to do a video one day next week where I go through all the books I've bought and got signed at Yalk and just do like a haul. Now I'm just going to find somewhere to chill out for a bit until the next panel. Well, I actually took a detour. It's nearly 5 o'clock. There's one more panel that I want to go to. I can't remember what it's about, but it's got really Schwab. I actually went outside to go and get a bit of fresh air and it was raining. And it was just absolute heaven.
The author Sinclair's Mysteries, and I'm also the host of children's books, radio show, and podcast, Down the Rabbit Hole, which might give you a clue as to why I am dressed like this today. And I'm also part of the original team behind Yalk, with each other, when we come to Yalk each year, which is books, and especially the books that inspire us and have impacted us and shaped who we are. And I am delighted to be joined by three incredible authors who I know you will all have enjoyed hearing already today. So we have V.E. Schwab, Lainey Taylor and Joanne Harris. So can we give them all a very warm Yalk welcome? Specifically, you know, what your relationship to books has been and was when you were growing up. I mean, have you always been readers? Were you voracious readers as a child? I mean, V.E., what about you?
To be honest, I was a very proficient reader, but I was not a good reader at all. I didn't enjoy reading when I was a child. I was an only child, and I was incredibly driven and wanted to be taken seriously at all times, and so I thought that meant I had to pick the most difficult books to read from the youngest age, and all my eyes had to do was see each and every word on the page, and that's what reading was, right? If you read each of the words, and you knew each of the words, that was reading. And it wasn't until my first kind of formative reading experience, which I won't say because I'll hold off on it until we talk about that, that reading became experiential, and I realized that if you found the right story, the world would disappear from around you, and you would forget who you were and where you were. It's 20-year-old me, and it is so much a time capsule for who I was, and I learned through the writing of it. So like how the writing shapes me, the execution of each and every book makes me who I am when I write the next book, right? So if you were to read my books in order, the idea is that I am growing as a person and as a writer through the executing of the books. Yes, I'm going and having life experiences too, and I'm have things going on outside of the books, but who I am comes out most when I am writing. And so Vicious was written to 25-year-old me and is completely indicative of 25-year-old me. And the Shades of Magic series is 27 to 29-year-old. And so they are each me. And I think I owe who I am now and what I'm writing now to each and every one of the books that I wrote before. So I take more chances, perhaps, with each book. I take different directions. There are things I could get away with. At my 13th book, like with the shape with Savage Song and Dark Duet, I knew I could get away without romance because I also was like not a debut author and I didn't have to have that fight with my publishers of like, does it need a romance? I was like, no, it doesn't, and they trusted me. So I get to take some new chances with each book, but really the biggest thing is just the making of each book makes me the person I am for the next.
Well, everybody who's donated, it's been amazing. And actually, thank you for anybody who hasn't donated but has been really enthusiastic about it anyway. But if you wanted to be a bit more than enthusiastic, you can still donate by the Just Giving link in my like pinned tweet on Twitter. Just saying. But yeah, or you can just throw some money in the jar. The current total that we've raised so far for the Royal Hospital for Neurodisability is £2,430. And that's without my mum donating, because she refuses to, because she thinks what I'm doing is hideous. She was like, I'll pay you to keep your hair. I'm like, that's not how this works. So thank you very, very much. And thank you very much to Walker, who have been ridiculously supportive. Know and love and trust, would like to have a go at shaving off a bit of my head, as hair, as well. Don't leave anything in my head. You can also just come up and have, like, pop a fiver in there and just do it on the head. Rosie will be in charge of that. Otherwise,
author David Owen of The Fallen Children Fight, which I have to keep introducing you as, is going to shave my head. It was going out for number one, that's short, right?
Having her head shaved and we were all watching, which was brilliant, Benedict Cumberbatch came out of the door to walk through the floor with the outfit, which was just hilarious. He just sort of turned and looked and thought, this is a look of absolute shock. So, so funny. Today's been wonderful. I think things are closing now. Yes, it's been great. We're going to start heading to the tube. Right. It's a bit drizzly at the moment, so I've put my mac on. But today, day two of Yauk was so much fun. I got to meet all of the authors that I wanted to meet. I had quite a few books signed. I bought a few books, not as many as yesterday, I don't think. I don't know how many I've bought, I'm losing track, but I've had a really fun day. I've got to see a few people I met at YA Shop, Lily and some others, and it was really nice. And I got to meet someone who watched yesterday's video from Yauk, who you all met in the video earlier. It was really lovely to just meet someone who saw yesterday's video and thought she'd say hi. That was nice. I like that. So, I'm going to stop vlogging in the rain, go back to where I'm staying, after getting some dinner, edit this and upload it tonight. So if you enjoyed this, give it a thumbs up, let me know who your favourite author is, and I will see you tomorrow for the last day of Yauk. Damn, it's going quick. Bye guys.
Subscribe to this guy for even more good times.